Now we are going to enter a really strange area of our experiments. These are the experiments of the projected states. Very unfamiliar and very alien for many of the seekers. So here is the warning once again. These experiments are not to be done by unqualified seekers or by ordinary people. The objective is same. Total control over the states or the activities of the memory. It is a very strange state, but as you will find out, it is the major state in our greater lives. This life in the form of a human is a tiny fraction of the greater life. So we start learning from now onwards. A special objective becomes to get control over the states or the activities in other worlds and also after death. So this is an extended goal there. It's not possible to do that in waking or dreaming states. The prerequisites are as before. Plus, you should have an extra healthy body, very healthy mind, and you should do a lot of purification before you try these experiments. Plus, the list is growing now and you will need a lot of awareness and attention in waking and dreaming state. We are assuming that you have already mastered these two states. Even if not, you can start. All these three kinds of experiments can be done together. But usually, it's not fruitful. If there is no awareness in the waking state, it will be very difficult to become aware in dream state. And if you're not used to the dream state, it is near impossible to get any awareness in the projected state. Even if you get there, it's not going to last for more than 1 or 2 seconds. It will be all accidental. It will be all coincidental. So anyhow, before we proceed, I want to tell you that it is not really important to do these experiments. All the knowledge that you want is available in any state. The waking state is good enough to get all the knowledge that you want. Remember, the waking state is also a dream. It is also a projected state. It is our ignorance that we think that waking state is the real one. No states are real. In all of them, we see the same illusion. There is an experience, which is illusory. There is an experiencer, which is real. That's all. This is the same story everywhere in every state. Nothing new will be learnt. So those who are not interested in the control or such things, they can skip this whole video or 2 or 3 parts of these videos. These experiments were always kept in dark for some reason. They come under occult experiments. They are not occult, but they became like this because of the secrecy. And these are treated as special states of memory. Abnormal, extraordinary, paranormal states. But there is nothing like this. It is perfectly normal. We enter these states every night or whenever you sleep. It is a natural state. What is missing is awareness and attention and the memory of what happened there. Just like all of your sleep state, all of your dreaming states, you don't remember anything. And most of your waking state, you don't remember everything in the waking state. Only a few important events, that's all you remember. They are also going to go away. So just because I'm not aware, there is no memory, does not make it special. It is special in a bad way, that it is a degraded state and nobody is really aware in those states. Very, very few people can manage awareness in these states, projected states. So if you're wondering what is projected states, then we'll define it. But it also means that you have skipped the basic knowledge. So I would recommend that you go and listen to all the videos that came earlier. I'm not going to redefine the memory layers and the worlds and areas in the universal memory and all this technical jargon will not be repeated. Except I'll throw some light on the projected states themselves. What are they? First of all, they are just a natural state of memory. There are natural activities in those states. Remember, they are not my states. I'm only a witness. The states come and go. I stay. And these are the experiences. They also come and go. Not my experiences. And these experiences are of causal memory, greater memory, and universal memory most of the time. Very rarely there will be an experience that involves the waking state world. And now we cannot distinguish between the dreaming and projected states, because dreaming becomes a special kind of projected state where the experience are restricted to a smaller part of the memory. A distinguishing feature of these states is a projected body. Just like in the dream state there is a dream body, in the projected states there will be projected bodies, and they are completely malleable and you can turn them into anything whimsically. Although they seem real and we have a tendency to assume the human form, that is not a requirement. There is another thing you will notice here, that there are various senses which are not really present in the dreaming or waking state. There are non-physical senses, and there can be hundreds of kinds of senses. That is why it is very difficult to make a memory bridge between the waking and the projected states, even if they happen in complete awareness. It will be very difficult to make sense of what is happening there in the waking state because of the mismatch of the sense data. You will need to translate the sensory experiences of the projected states into the language of the senses that are present in the waking state. This is a complicated matter, but we do have this natural ability to do that, so nothing serious. Go and get the experiences. You will learn all these translations and formations of the memory bridges. I don't know of any specific techniques to do that. I only know that you get this ability. Just like a baby gets the ability to walk and talk. It's built in into us. But these bodies and senses are dependent on the worlds. So it looks like that the body, the senses and the worlds, they form a set, they always occur together. A specific set will occur together. For example, it is not possible to take your physical body in a projected state. Or it is not possible to get into the projected state with our ordinary five senses functioning. There will be a different set of bodies and senses for different states that come under the projected category. Sometimes you end up in rule-bound areas, and there the body is not malleable. Senses are given, the bodies are given to you. It is more like a possession case. Just like this one, the waking state is a possession case. We did not create the bodies, simply possessed them, occupied them. We are using the senses which are built in. We did not decide which senses we want. So this is very much common in the rule-bound areas, but sometimes there can be exceptions, you see. This is the illusion, so everything is possible in the illusion, but normally there are rules or laws. Now, I'm not going to tell you what do these experiences involve, because I think it will be useless. They are not comparable to waking state or dreaming state experiences. It is very difficult to even talk about a dream, because it is so different from the waking state, but not that different. There are places, there are houses, cars, roads, people. It is almost a copy, a very badly made copy of the waking world, the dreaming state. You can talk about the dream, but it is strange. But the projected states, they are stranger. The experiences there do not directly translate into any of our waking or dreaming state experiences. Everybody interprets them differently, depending on their capability and long experiences in these other worlds. There is a rule that more experience you get, the better you become at interpreting them. One or two experiences, well, they are so strange that they're easily forgotten. As soon as you reach here, you stop being a human. Why did I say that? What do I become? Don't worry, you remain human in the waking state. This hairless, tailless monkey. But suddenly you know that you are not a human. Any kind of body is possible. Any kind of mind, any kind of senses are possible. You no longer remain a member of the species of the humans. as soon as you're back in the waking state, the waking state will feel very strange, not the projected states. Our nature is a free being, not bound by bodies or worlds. So when we come back in the waking state, or after a long experience, many years of experience in the projected states, the feeling or the knowing that I am a human completely disappears. I am not a human already, but these experiences, these experiments, they have a direct and lasting and very deep effect on your whole being. So let us take a look at the map of the projected states. Just like the dreaming state, you will find that there is a universal memory here, the biggest oval. And now I am showing something which was missing in the previous diagrams in the dreaming state experiments. There are these large areas that I am calling the greater memories, the non-individualized memory spaces. These spaces include the physical worlds and any other worlds. And as usual, there is the causal memory, inside which is the waking state memory, which I sometimes call the local memory, and the very longish circle. It is the domain of the projected states. So you can see that it is a very general word now. The actual experience depends on where you are in this map. All of them are projected states, yes. Now you can see that it includes the waking state. Waking state is a kind of projected state. It's nothing special. And it includes the dreaming completely. Plus, this time something extraordinary can happen, that this state extends into greater memory and the neighboring clusters of the greater memories. Plus, you can touch or you can connect to other causal bodies, which means you can get in contact with other entities. They won't look like causal bodies, because causal body has no shape usually, but they take on a shape, they take on a form if they want to react, if they want to interact with you. Just like you get a projected body, they can also do that. So you can imagine that this is going to be a very long talk. I can actually make a whole series on experiments of the projected states only, 20, 30, 40 episodes. But don't worry, I'm not going to do that. It is your experiment. And anyhow, there are hundreds of books on the projected states. There are 20, 30 techniques, and millions have experienced them. And I think thousands are actively working in this area. They're exploring these states, and they come back and they tell us. And almost all of you have been there. You don't remember. It is very natural. It happens every night. So some people are going to call them as astral projections, but the word astral is already corrupted, so I dropped it. It only involves a few layers, and in my opinion, that is a very small part of the projected states. Yes, it is the easiest kind of experience, the astral one, but it mostly involves the dream body and a little bit of emotional layers. That's all there is. Mostly like a dream. And then there are more kinds of projections that are given in the occult books or in the modern translation of the literature about these states. Some may want to call it the etheric projections or mental projections, or even the astral light body, or in the East we can call them as subtle bodies, subtle worlds, or the lokas, the other worlds. Now, let me tell you, when you are standing in a world, which is not this one, in front of a being which is as solid and real as you and me, the whole subtleness is thrown out of the window. There is nothing subtle about the subtle worlds. They are just as gross as this one. So, none of these words, they really suit my experience and probably experiences of other people. And there is a very, very dumb kind of word for it. It is called out-of-body experiences, which is probably the most common word on the internet, at least. Now, you will notice that it is not out-of-body. The body is an illusion. There is nothing which is out-of-body, and there is nothing which is inside the body. You do not leave the body, because you never occupied the body, never went in the body. So if you're wondering why, it means you did not listen to all those past episodes in this series. We have nothing to do with bodies. The bodies are just impermanent experiences. So you will get a body, projected body. So from one body to another body, there is nothing out of the body here. You can say out of the world, but then you land in some other world. Yes, but literally they are out of the world experiences. The bodies and these things, they are kind of disposable. So I'm giving it a very general name now, the projected states, which includes all these names in them. Eastern, Western, occult, and modern, whatever. And as I said, the experience will depend on your place in this map. So depending on the map, you can label it like this was this experience number even, experience E2, E3, E4, like this. It can go into hundreds, but I don't think anybody has mapped it so precisely. People in the ancient times, they have explored it extensively, and they can only produce a layered structure, just like we already saw. They saw there is a hierarchy in these experiences. So yes, you can give it your own names. You're free to do that. Many people have done that. I have my own names actually, but that is going to make this video very long, and it is not really important because you can use your names. When we talk about it, yes, then the names can cause problems because everybody calls it with a different name, and that is why there is no standard exploration so far. I've never seen any standard exploration. There was a time when it was a standard, but now it is all lost. So I'm not going to name those states, but there is something important that we should name, and that is called the state of death. And death is a state. It is a projected state. And it also involves the experiences of the causal memory, greater memory, and universal memory. And there is no difference between a projected state and a death state, except that there is no coming back. The physical body is completely destroyed. That is the definition of death. There is no physical body to come back into the waking state. And so in short, we can say that death is a projection from which you never come back. It is nothing to worry about because this happens millions of times. It is a routine thing for any entity, and it is going to happen any day for you and me. So if there is no awareness, obviously nothing will be remembered. Nothing will be recalled. You don't recall dying. You don't recall taking births. You don't recall anything of the projected states or after death or before life, or nothing is there because you were never aware. And if there is something, that means you already are a seeker. You are already seeking. If you pop out of the body, like they say, every now and then, that means there are tendencies in you already. You are a long-term seeker. These experiments, they span many lifetimes. It is not something which you do in one day and know everything. No, many lifetimes, hundreds and hundreds of years. Remember, we are in a spiritual field. Here the time means nothing. So probably I'll do an episode on death, and surely there are articles and podcast episodes already on death. There are many, if you are interested. As I said, how do I know all these things? If we do not maintain awareness, we are not going to remember anything. And yes, I also don't remember anything. I don't remember so much. All I know is I have the tendencies. That's all I know. The rest is a logical extrapolation. And after a few of these experiments, they have taken a solid form now, so that I can write something, I can tell you something about these states and how to do the experiments. That much I can tell, and the rest you need to gather yourself. You need to do your own experiments and fill in the blanks. Who knows, you may recall something. Recall is the key, actually. Why? Because the projections are happening every night, and the states in between deaths and births, they are happening probably thousands of times. There is nothing special in these states. What has happened is because of non-awareness, darkness, we don't remember them now. Anything that happened naturally, we do not remember it. We do not remember any of the past lives, which are just projected states. And that is because of the same reason. There is no awareness, there is no attention. We never did any kind of practice. And we never had this knowledge, most probably. Probably 10% of those who are listening, they are long-term seekers. But the rest of us, the 90%, we are newbies. So those who are exploring since many lifetimes, they have a little bit of recall and they have the ability to recall also. This boils down to the memory bridge. You need a memory bridge between the projected states and the waking states. Otherwise, you won't be able to recall anything from the waking state in the projected state. And you won't be able to recall anything which happened in the projected state in the waking state. Remember, you call your waking state your life. So in this life, you don't know anything because there is no memory bridge. How to form the memory bridge? We have discussed this thing in detail previously. It is formed because of awareness. Be aware. Awareness is the key. What are these projected worlds? It is a kind of wrong name here because the worlds are not projected. We project ourselves in the worlds. So anyhow, I'm going to call it the projected worlds because there is no other name for it. You can call them the astral domains or the subtle worlds or the higher worlds, but it is not that meaningful. That which is subtle or astral or whatever can appear as solid and real as this world. Yes, this world has a name. Very strange. So what are these projected worlds? You can simply call them experiences in the projected bodies. When we leave the waking state and we are not in the dreaming state or the sleep state, wherever we find ourselves, if we gain awareness, that will be a projected world. It can be any kind of experience. It can be something like the planet Earth experience, or it can be like a small dream, or it can be completely void, darkness. It can be heavenly, it can be hellish. There is no limit. There are infinite variety there. The projected worlds are not located. They should be understood. You do not get out of this body and then travel and then go into a projected world. There is no airline called projected airlines. Nothing like this. There is no travel involved here. It is not a location. Although the word location itself comes from the lok, which means a world, a projected world. But this is memory. You can call it a memory location if you want. I usually call it the memory areas instead of locations. It is completely a non-local experience, the projected worlds. Some of the areas are rule-bound and then you get a very specific, very solid experience there. And yes, it is going to appear real. Sometimes it is more real than this waking world. Other characteristics of projected worlds is that they will have their own kind of objects, non-physical objects, people, creatures, entities, and there will be locations within the worlds. The worlds are not located, the locations are in the worlds. And they will have their own time, their own scale of times, which have no correspondence with our waking state time. It is all an illusion, so it can be anything. 50 years in the projected worlds can look like 5 minutes of the waking state. It is possible. But the essence remains the same. These objects, these people, and everything that you see there is just memory. This memory is interpreted using the projected senses, which are hosted on the projected body, and they are experienced by the experiencer. It is exactly like this. You are sitting and listening to me. It is a projected world, which is a memory. You are experiencing it using senses, which are hosted in the body, and you are the experiencer. So, no essential difference, except probably you will find them strange because we are used to this world. Creatures from other worlds, if they project here, they are going to find this extraordinary and very, very strange, unlike anything. These worlds, you can manipulate them sometimes. Sometimes the rules are not so tight, you can change things. And surely the time can be manipulated in any world. Once you know these are illusions, the abilities open up. You don't know that you can do this because of ignorance, that's all. Once you start manipulating, you will become an expert in no time. So much so that you can create your own world. You can manifest something which is small or big, strange or plain, like a simple temple hanging in the cloud somewhere in the blank area in the universal memory, no man's land. Or you can create the whole solar system and whole universe also and let it evolve. Probably somebody has done this for us here in our physical universe. It is possible to do that simply by intention. Probably I'm going to have more episodes on intention and creation and manifestation. It is fun, but these things are not under the path of knowledge. We usually throw them under the occult practices, occult paths. But there are no rules that you cannot do these experiments. There are no rules that you cannot get these experiences. You can. They are not necessary. So we are in such a world, probably created by some explorer. And the explorer is now so big that we call it the greater memory or something like that. It contains many such universes. Strangely, this world where we are right now is very special and unique. And yes, just like I said, there is a name for this one. I don't have any names for any other worlds, but this one has a name and we call it the Death World. And it is very beautiful and unique name. Why? Not because there is death and destruction here, because the creatures here, the inhabitants here, they believe in the reality of the death. There is so much ignorance here that the birth and death are seen as real and the bodies are taken as myself. So the death world is a very apt name for this world. It is defined by this phenomena of death, which everybody is afraid of. So you can take it as a standard measure and you can start classifying the worlds depending on where they are in terms of ignorance and darkness. So this one is kind of bottom world, lower world, we call it a lower world, but there are lower than this. And there are obviously higher worlds than this world. So it totally depends on your own level of evolution, where you land up. And why do we classify it like this? Because we prefer the higher worlds. We don't want to go lower than the death world. You're already here. Enjoy the lowest of lowly, which you will find everything here in this world. But we don't find the heavenly experiences here, so we want to go higher, not lower. And that is why sometimes we compare the worlds with the death world. So we can begin exploring it, and I'm going to tell you the tools and techniques to enter the projected states in the next episode.